Good morning students, today we are going to study the chapter Advertising and Brand Promotion. Dear students, in our last chapter we studied about 4 P's: price, place, promotion and product. Out of that, 1 P was promotion mix. So there are 4 elements of promotion mix. One is advertising, another is salesmanship, next is promotion, and fourth is publicity. So advertising is one of the elements of promotion mix which we are going to study today. This word advertising has been derived from the Latin word advertere. Advertere means turn to. The main purpose of advertising is to turn the attention of consumers towards the products, towards the goods, towards the services. That is why this advertising word has been created. According to Philip Kotler, who has given definition of advertising, he says that it is any form of non-personal presentation and promotion of ideas, goods or services identified by a sponsor is called advertising. Why do we people go for the advertising? When we have to introduce any product in the market, there is a need for advertising. When an existing product, we want that this product should remain constant or should continue its existence in the market, we want advertisement. For building the brand preference, there are many brands available or different brands available of every product in the market. So why will people choose your product? So to build this brand preference, that whenever the name of the biscuits comes in our mind, we use word Parle. The first word comes in our mind is Parle, whether we eat it or not. When the word, when we talk about cake, the first word comes Britannia. There is no one company only existing of cake. There are several companies producing cakes. Priya Gold, Parle and many other product companies. But the word first comes Britannia. So this Britannia company has got this brand preference. To eliminate middlemen, sometimes to reach the product in the hands of consumers, we have to appoint several middlemen, those who help in reaching the products in the hands of consumer or to make aware about the product to the consumers. But when we go for the advertisement, the consumer itself asks for the particular product at the shop. So to eliminate these middlemen is a requirement of advertising, to support the dealers, to build goodwill. For these purposes we want the advertising of any product. Now we can say advertising has following features. One is non-personal. It is a non-personal activity. Why it is called non-personal? Because there is no face-to-face contact between the advertiser and the consumer. There is no contact between the advertiser and customer. So it is a non-personal activity. Mass communication and advertising leads to mass communication. For several people are watching or several people are targeted in any advertisement. It is a paid communication. The sponsors or the companies are paying amount, good amount for this advertising. Identified sponsor, sponsors are identified in any of the advertisement. It is also told why, who has given this advertisement. Britannia Company Limited, Parley Company Limited, Rance Limited, Airtel Limited. It is informed. And information and persuasion. The information is provided through the advertisement. Now, we talk about types of advertising. Types of advertising. Under this, the first advertisement comes product advertisement. Product advertising is that advertising where the main purpose of advertising is to promote or sell any of the product. Any of the product, it might be good or tangible product, or it might be a services in an intangible. So next is institutional advertising. Institutional advertising, the main purpose of this advertising is to build a favorable image of an organization, not of any product. Means no biscuit or cake is not advertised here. Advertisement is made of Britannia. Advertisement is made of Reliance. Reliance company is producing several products. Bajaj motorcycle, not a single one motorcycle, not Pulsar, Discover, Avenger or any other. So it is called institutional advertising, means an institution or a company is promoting. Third is informative advertising. Informative advertising means any advertising where the main aim of advertising is to make aware of the uses of the products or services. People are informed how to use the product, like save petrol is one of the advertising which is called informative advertising. Apart from this, there are 2-3 more advertising, like reminder advertising, where aim is to remind about the product. Concept advertising, where no product is promoted, like it is said, Heera hai sada ke liye, diamond is forever. That is called concept advertising. So here this topic ends. In our next lecture, we will be discussing about different other advertising concepts. Till then, thank you. Goodbye.